Many villages in Uttar Pradesh's Muzaffarnagar and Shamli districts were destroyed as a result of the communal violence that erupted in September 2013. 60 people from both the Hindu and Muslim communities were killed in these riots. Before the riots, Kutuba was home to approximately 2,500 Muslims. Now, hauntingly desolate mosques are the last remaining testaments of the Muslim communities that lived here. 8 Muslims were killed in Kutuba and their houses were set ablaze during the riots. The people from the Muslim community who fled the village during the riots never returned. Those displaced from Hindu-majority villages have moved to new settlements. Abdul Basit, who left the village of Lisad, now lives in such a settlement in Kandla. Basit's life has not come back on track, even after a decade.
आप देख रहे होंगे मेरे कच्चे मकान हैं, छत भी कच्ची है, बरसात में चूता है, बच्चों को मेरे एक वक्त खाना मिलता है, एक वक्त नहीं मिलता है। ये सब लोग इसी तरह जिंदगी बसर कर रहे हैं। गांव याद आता है, लेकिन दिल नहीं करता लौटने का। याद आता है। गांव की हर चीज याद आती है। मदरसे याद आते हैं, मस्जिदें याद आती हैं, जो आजादी से घूमते थे वो याद आता है, सब कुछ याद आता है। 10 साल हो गए आज तक डर झुका तो है उस गांव के पास में को निकलना भी हमारे लिए वही दहशत का मंजर सामना।
The special investigation team that was constituted in the wake of the Muzaffarnagar riots inspected 510 lawsuits, but the court issued sentences for only 3 cases. One is a rape case in which the 2 accused have been given life sentences. However, the victim feels that the punishment given to the perpetrators is insufficient.
मैं रोती रही, चिल्लाती रही, उन्होंने मेरी एक न सुनी और भारी बारी से मेरे साथ भी रेप किया तीनों मुलजिमों ने। तब से बहुत बीमार रहती हूँ मैं अभी बीमार हूँ और मेरे दिमाग में से जहन में से वो बातें नहीं निकल पाती जो मैंने जिंदगी जी है। अपना सब कुछ खोया है मैंने, अपना गांव छोड़ा, ये सजा भी मुझे तो ऐसा लग रहा कि सजा भी कमी है उनके लिए, तो उन्हें तो बस फांसी की सजा होनी चाहिए थी।
On August 27, 2013, 3 men, Shahnawaz, Sachin and Gaurav, were killed in an act of violence in the village of Kawal in Muzaffarnagar. The deaths of the Muslim and Jat men ignited communal tensions in the region. Multiple village council meetings were held and undercurrents of anger continue to gather steam. After less than 2 weeks of the incident, widespread violence erupted in the village. Sachin was married and had a son. His wife was granted a government job after his death. She lives in Muzaffarnagar now, away from his family. Sachin's mother spends most of her time alone.
जो अचानक मैं इस तरह मारे हुए तुम कहां भूल जाओगे।
Gaurav's father, Ravinder Chaudhary, had to stay in jail for a few months on charges of Shahnawaz's murder. The legal proceedings in the case are ongoing. He is saddened by the politicization of his son's death.
In मामलों में परिवार तो उजड़ ही जा, मैं कमाई का साधन बंद हो जा, रोज कचहरी के कोर्ट के चक्कर काटने पड़े, उसमें पैसा लगे और मानसिक रूप से भी टूट जा आदमी।
6 members of Shahnawaz's family, including his 2 brothers, are serving jail sentences on charges of Sachin and Gaurav's murders.
सबसे बड़ा अफसोस तो यही है कि भाई बेटा मर गया, जेल चले गए, सुनवाई कोई नहीं।
Residents say that Muzaffarnagar has moved on from the 2013 riots. The hatred that grew between Hindus and Muslims is subsiding. However, the lingering question is whether those who endured the worst will ever see justice served.